Relax your shoulder. Inhale and exhale slowly. Now you raise your arms up. So you keep your right hand at the front, keep your left hand at the back. And try to raise your arm up towards ceiling. Inhale and exhale slowly. Try to bring your arms up higher and higher. Five, four, yes, three, two, one. Then release slowly. And now keep your left hand at the front. Interlock your finger and again, raising your arms up. So try to raise your arms up towards ceiling. Come on, five, four, three, two, one, and relax. Good, good. Take a deep breath. Now from here, hold your elbows with your both hands. Take a deep breath. Inhale, reaching your arms up. And gently side bending to the left and circle your body from left to the right side. Perfect. Five. Three. Two. One more deep breath. And now reverse, reverse. Yep, open your chest, inhale and exhale. Five. Four, good, good. Three. Two. And one. Then relax. Now bring your hand forward. So circle your wrist joint forward for 10, 9, yes, 8, 7, 6, 5. Good, good. 4, 3, 2, and reverse. 5, 4, 3, yes, 2, and one. Then relax. So keep one hand close to your baby. And keep the other hand close to your heart. Inhale. Bring the oxygen all the way down to the baby inside your womb. And exhale, relax the navel back. Inhale. Exhale. Just imagine every time you breathe in, you're sending the love, the happiness all the way down to your baby inside the womb. And imagine every time you're exhaling, you let go all the tiredness, the fatigueness, the sadness, the worriness away with your out-breath. Inhale, full of love and happiness. And exhale, feel your body getting lighter as you let go of the worriness and tiredness. One more deep breath here. And slowly open your eyes. So from here, I want you to keep your right foot at the top of your left knee. Okay? And check, do your best to keep your shin bone to be parallel on each other, like you stack on each other. And you're gonna try to pushing your right knee down towards the floor. One, two, yes. Three, good, good. Four, Five, leaning forward and sway your body to the front. Eight, nine, and 10. Then pushing your right knee down towards the floor softly and circle your body from right to the left. Two, yes. Three, you should feel the gentle stretch at the back of your right leg, yeah? One more deep breath here, inhale and exhale. And now keep your right foot down close to the left. And keep your right hand grab at your toes. Inhale here, big circle at your left shoulder and circle back. So give me four more deep breaths. Inhale, circle back, 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 back. Look back. Good, good. So three more deep breaths. Inhale. And now try to look, follow your left hand and back. So in this way, you won't hurt your neck. Yes. Inhale, open your chest and look, follow your left hand. One more round. And back to the center. Good job. And now we switch. So keep your left foot on the top of your right knee. Yes. And try to keep your shin bone be parallel to each other and pushing the left knee down. Yep. 10. Good, good. Do it gently and softly. 9. 8. 7. 6, 5, good, good, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Slowly from here, you're going to circle your body from left to the right side. Feel the gentle stretch at the back of your left leg. Yes. Give me another 3 deep breaths. 3, 2, 1, more deep breath, inhale and exhale. And now keep your left foot close to the right. Left hand hold at the toes and give me a big circle on your right shoulder. Look, follow your right hand. Yes, inhale and exhale. Good job. So give me 4 more deep breaths. Four, three, last two, one more time, and back to the center. And now from here, you keep your feet together. You're leaning forward and try to open your knees again. When you open the knee, just do it gently. If the knee didn't touch the floor, doesn't matter, right? We just try to opening the hip and leaning forward. 5, 6, yes. Seven. 8, yes, 9, and 10, leaning forward, hip opening, and hip circle. You can start with any side because we're going to do both sides, right? 3, 2, and 1. So remember the keyword, hip opening, leaning forward and hip circle. 3, 2, and 1. Inhale, open your chest, face up, look up. Now you exhale, round your spine and sigh out to your mouth like this. Primal sound. Two more deep breaths. One more time, let go all the tension that no longer serving you. And back to the center. So from here, let's stay in all four. So whenever you stay in all four, keep your shoulders above your hands, yeah? And keep your hips above the knee. Then from here, I would add more. Check from the back here. I'm sorry. Your toes gonna be wider than your knee. Because usually we're gonna do this way, right? So try to keep your toes wider than your knee. So in this way, you open the hip a little wider. Yep. And circle your body from one side to the other side. Add a little bit more to feel the deeper, turn the finger to the side like this. Yep. And you circle your body from one side to the other side. Inhale and exhale slowly. Two. Three. Four. And reverse, reverse. One. Yep. Two. Good, good. Three. Four. And five. Perfect. So now, tuck the toes, turn the finger towards to the front of the mat. Inhale here and exhale. Lift your body up to downward facing dog. So you keep the hip up higher and look to the back of the mat. Then from here, bend at your right knee and slowly bend at your left knee. It's going to be the single leg bend. Right knee bend, left knee bend. So do side by side. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then keep your knees down. Relax the toes together. So knees open, toes together. Give me a fist like this. And then rest your forehead on the fist. Inhale to your nose and sigh out to your mouth. Let go all the tension that no longer serving you. And for the next three deep breaths, when you exhale, we're gonna say the word Om together for three rounds. Remind yourself of Apana energy. Remind yourself of the primal sound. Let the energy go downward to the birth canal. And when you say this word, just imagine you try to open up the space at your birth canal and be ready for your baby to birthing down easier and smoother. Inhale. And now come up slowly. So step your left foot forward. And relax the right leg just in case, okay? Because if you feel any sensation below your knee, you might just use the towel to support below the knee. All right? Yes. Good, good. So keep your right leg back. Keep your left leg open. Yep. And from here, turn the toe slightly out and circle your hip. Open it. 1, 2. Good, good. 3. 4, 5. Yep. 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So move your foot to be aligned with your knees. So keep your right foot to be aligned with your left knee. And slowly from here, rest your right arm on your right knee, yeah? And you give me, I'm gonna show you from this direction. So it's gonna be like this position. Yep, and just give me a big circle on the opposite shoulder. 3, 2, and 1. Then reverse. 3, 2, and 1. So from this side, then you switch to the other side. Same here, right? Turn. Now your left side, the toes out, and slowly circle the hip out. You can do like this, or you can keep your hands support to the floor. 4, 5, 6, yes, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Then you keep your foot be aligned with your knee. So keep your forearm rest. Yes, the other side. Then give me a circle at your right shoulder now. Good. 3, 2, and reverse, reverse. 3, 2, and 1. Then back to the center. So when you come back to the center here, keep your palms down, tuck the toes, and walk your hands back towards to the knees. Take a deep breath. Inhale, looking straight. Exhale, look down to the floor. Then inhale, bring your arms up. Now have a look again. So you hinge your hip to the back wall, knees bend. Inhale here and exhale, walk your hands towards and you keep your knees down. And up, lift the hip up high. Walk your hands back towards your knees. Inhale, looking straight. Exhale, look down. Then inhale, rest your arms up over the head. So give me one more round here. Exhale, lower your hands down. Keep your knees bent. And slowly walk your hands forward. And lower the knees down softly. Inhale. Exhale. Hands on knees. Exhale. look down. Inhale, bring your arms up. So slowly from here, we're going to use the ball. So you're going to go to get your ball. 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10. And then sit on the ball. Oh yeah. So whenever you sit on the ball shake, yeah, we try to keep the feet flat to the floor. Keep the knees open. Then you circle the hip from one side to the other side. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Good, good. 3, 2, and 1. Then you reverse and shake. Yeah, we try to keep our feet flat to the floor and knees bend around 90 degrees. So if you feel that you need to inflate the air to the ball, I recommend, because I think I want you to add more, the ball a little bit soft. I just feel it. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So from here, shake. I'm gonna show you from the other side, all right? So we call this one the pelvic rock. First of all, shake. You're gonna move your hip back and forward, back and forward. So if you have no ball, this should be the position. So like this, back and front, back and front. So you're gonna try to push your hip forward, hip forward. So now with the ball, it's gonna be kinda easier. 1, 2, 3, 4, perfect. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Relax the shoulder. Keep one hand close to your baby. Keep the other hand close to your heart. Inhale, bring the oxygen, the love, the happiness all the way down to your baby inside your womb. And exhale. Let go all the tension, the worriness that no longer serves in you. And slowly open your eyes. The next breathing technique we call the J breathing. Just imagine the alphabet J. So from on the top, and then it's going to be the J down, right? So imagine that when you exhale, the energy travel towards to your spinal bone. So every vertebra all the way to your tailbone and out to your birth canal. So you just see about that. So inhale and exhale. And out. But you're making the primal sound with the J alphabet. So when you inhale, I just have to write in this way. Wah. So right now, this is the lecture class. Inhale here, right? And then exhale. So here is your head. And this is your spine. And it's out here is your birth canal or your J. Your vagina is here. Your head is here. Inhale and go out this direction. So it's a J breathing. What kind of imagination? So yeah, with a J breath, wah, oh, don't go anywhere. So with a J breathing, making the primal sound Okay, so it's going to be inhale and yes. So, and visualize the J breath. Down and out. Okay, get ready. We're going to do this for 3 deep breaths. Making the J breath when you're exhaling as long as you can. It's not a J, it's going to be kind of sigh out. All right. So relax your shoulders. Take a deep breath. Inhale. So now you combine the primal sound with the J breathing, so you know exactly what is going to be the direction you let the air down and out. Okay, so all the way and out to your birth canal. I want you to ask me, but the thing is I can't hear your voice. Can you try to unmute or something? Because even though I put this one on, I still can hear your voice. Mm-hmm. Check again. Can you try to say something? I still can't hear you. All right, so let's do one thing that if you have any question regarding about the J breathing, just send me that the voice message on the WhatsApp. Yeah? Okay, so let me show you a few more exercise that you can using the ball. Number one, we are talking about the hip circle. When you do the circle, again, make sure that you keep your feet flat to the floor. And it would be great that you try to open your hip, yeah? This is number one, the hip circle. Number two, the pelvic tilt or the pelvic rock. That's right. Then number three, what we did, we're sitting here and we try to do the J breath. Then number four, from here, you keep your sit bone resting on the ball, left knee bend, right leg straight. Inhale from here and exhale, left forearm down and right arm up. Good. So you can see that we keep the lower part to stay steady. We move only from the side of our body. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Another two round. One more deep breath. Good, good. Then back to the center. So do the same on the other side. You keep your left leg straight. You keep your right knee bent. So make sure you try to keep your feet flat to the floor. Yeah. So I don't want you to open your leg or relax the left knee this way. So make sure that activate your both inner thigh. So inhale from this one, that the reverse warrior, and exhale. So give me another four deep breaths. Inhale and exhale. Do slowly control the move with the lower part stay steady. Last two. So one more time here. Inhale and exhale. Then back to the center. So another exercise that you can do the ball that we call the bouncing. So with the bouncing, I want you to do gently. Like we're walking, so when you walk, we try to put the tension down to the pelvic area and just helping the baby to keep the head down. Same with the bouncing here as well. However, when you do gently, it should be like this, right? You don't be like, woohoo, woohoo. So it should not be that way, unless that you're okay with that. But my recommend is just like gentle bouncing. Like, okay, inhale. And let me come closer to you. Day one, we're learning the long and deep breath. Inhale and exhale. Inhale long, but you keep your exhaling even longer. Then we're learning the humming bee sound, right? Because again, exhaling gonna be longer than inhaling. So when you're making the humming bee sound, it's gonna be as long as possible. Keep the tip of your tongue pressing to the palate. Close your ear, your eyes. Inhale. So you make the exhaling longer than the inhaling. And you also make your exhaling as long as you can, right? Then today, we learn also that the J breath, how we do the primal sound, but in the alphabet J. Inhale and out, down and out from your birth canal. I want you to visualize whenever you do this one, the J breath, you try to soften and open up your pelvic floor area. At the bottom of your pelvic, this is more about I let go, I let go. Or imagine when you want to pee and you're making this sound because you want just like, I want to just relax the pelvic floor and I want my pee to go down, and how you try just like making the sound and relax the pelvic floor muscles area. Okay, then another breathing that is also good to learn as well, but you need to listen carefully. So you're gonna be inhale, inhale, exhale, exhale. It's gonna be like this. Check for my belly, hey? I just have to standing a little bit. So, inhale, inhale, exhale, exhale, inhale, inhale, exhale, exhale. So it's gonna be. So it's not hyperventilation, but you make like a two rhythm of your inhaling and two rhythm of your exhaling. So Inhale, belly expand. Inhale, belly expand. Exhale, belly in. Exhale, belly in. So. Then inhale deep and exhale. So you learn so many techniques. If you ask me when I'm going to use this one, awesome. Once your labor intensity getting stronger and stronger, you're going to be like, and now you're going to feel that, oh, okay, I need more oxygen now. So you're going to go. So you're going to combine using all the technique when your instinct telling you. Then again, wrap up. We learn long and deep breath. You know the technique that you're going to keep the exhaling longer than the inhaling. And once you're making sound when you're exhaling, your oxygen gonna come easier. And when we're making sound, either you're making the humming bee sound or you're making the primal sound, or that we call the J breath. Also we call this one short inhaling, short exhaling, to allow you to draw the focus into your body.